Look at this, the size is crazy. I've never seen such a small MCU development board with a camera module. If you know anything, please leave it in the below comment, I'd like to check it out. Officially, its dimensions are a length of 17.5mm, a width of 21mm, and a height of 15mm. It's made very small. Also, since the USB serial chip is included inside, there is no need for separate debugging board for flashing. This is really good. In the case of ESP32 cam AI thinkerboard, we always connect it to serial port through FTDI programmer. I believe everyone agrees with how annoying this is. It used two boards stacked. The camera board extends over their ESP32-S3 board. The camera board and the main ESP32-S3 board are connected by a board-to-board connector. And there is a 24-pin connector for attaching a DVP image sensor. Officially supports the OV2640 and OV5640. I will test the OV5640 when I get a chance. It's gonna be very interesting. ESP32 boards usually include a built-in antenna. Since this requires making the PCB larger, in these small devices, the antenna can be connected externally to reduce the PCB size. This is not a bad choice as it can have better transmit and receive rates than the built-in antenna. Since the micro SD card is also included in the camera board, you can use it for any purpose. After connecting the SD card, if you attach the OV2640 over it, it seems to be fixed and doesn't seem to be rattling. Overall, it's very good. Let's compare with ESP32 cam AI thinkerboard here. Less than half of it. Oh man, even ESP32 cam does not include USB serial chip. Just because there is no built-in antenna, it's inconvenient to connect an external antenna, but I don't think it's a big deal because it can be put inside the enclosure if you have it. Looking at this again, the size of this device is truly amazing. If there is a camera board smaller than this that can be developed, please let me know. I really want to compare them. Let's have the operation test using camera web server, which is tested when we use ESP32 cam for the first time. The resolution is set to VGA 640x480 and it keeps streaming images. Of course, you can set it to 1600x1200, which is the maximum resolution of the OV2640, but I think 640x480 is the best one for the general streaming test. You can check the quality of images transferred over the network on the wrapped screen. It's original and has not been modified anything. The main screen in the middle is currently shot at 4K 30fps. Since they are shooting a highway, we can check the movement of the subject. You can see images are being acquired without any lag. It seems noise-free image acquisition is possible because of a stable power supply and smooth network environment. It's working very well without any problems. Since this device is made very small, I thought the system could be slowed down by heating up if it's continuously operated. The reason is that everything including the regulator is tightly packed inside one main chip. So this is because the ESP32 can get hot more easily and that will eventually slow down the system. On the right, I'm taking a system temperature measurement while it's working. I expected the regulator on the main board to be the hottest, but the OV2640 was the hottest. Currently, the maximum rod condition is continuing. The temperature of the main board is capped at around 55 degrees, it's Celsius. The OV2640 is also still working, it doesn't seem to go over 80 degrees. It may be different in the situation where you make an enclosure and put this device in it, but this is definitely a good enough device. This new device reminds me of my old Tic-Tac camera. I packed the ESP32 cam board, battery, and wireless charging module into the Tic-Tac case. I tried to make it small, but this was the best I could do at the time. If I ever do a project like a spy camera again, I think I'll make it the smallest by connecting a battery to this new ESP32-S3 sense board. Also, since the new board includes a microphone, I think I can try acquiring video and audio data at the same time. It's gonna be something different project. Anyway, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.